Hello and welcome. This is World Cup News Breakdown brought to you by Sri Lanka's number one sports hub, www.thepapare.com. We are talking about the 11th ICC Cricket World Cup 2015 being played in Australia and New Zealand, and today was the first quarter final at the Sydney Cricket Ground between Sri Lanka, who ended up in third place from Pool A, and South Africa, who had prepared tremendously and ended up in the second slot from Pool B. Joining me to discuss the match and beyond is Roshan Abeysinghe. He is a cricket administrator and a well-known international cricket commentator, together with former World Cup player and current cricketer, Jahan Mubarak. Welcome, gentlemen. Well, a situation where Sri Lanka really were outplayed by South Africa, but the statistics say a bigger story, Roshan.
I don't know whether we have enough time to discuss what went wrong. You see, in hindsight, we could talk a lot. But I'll let Jahan come up with his thoughts, but let me come up with my thinking. I felt Sri Lanka did a lot of things right by winning the toss. When I say a lot of things right, that was a huge thing, because I looked very closely at AB de Villiers' body language at the toss. And when Angelo Matthews won the toss and decided to bat, and when AB de Villiers was being spoken to, I felt he was edgy. He was nervous. The fact that South Africa had never won at a knockout stage, they came in with the idea of batting first. They wanted to put runs on the board. So Sri Lankan captain had called that toss correctly, won the first round, huge boost. But then, Haritha, I didn't understand why Sri Lanka just changed the batting order. I cannot accept the fact that they opened with Kusal. They should have played Kusal at number 6. Let's not forget that Kusal came into this side as a replacement. He was not a first choice player. Now, Sri Lanka had gone in right up to that game with two established openers. And what we needed was a stable opening partnership. Well, Sri Lanka gave Kusal the license, and then we did see what happened. Then I also felt that Sri Lanka was looking at, say, 300 plus. I didn't think it was a 300 plus pitch. Seriously thinking, I thought it had a bit for the bowlers. And in a quarter final, 260, 270, had we aimed for that, maybe we would have got 280, 290. I felt giving Kusal the license, go after the bowling, try and get to 300. Seemed to be the strategy. Kusal was lost, Dilshan was lost, and the biggest surprise to me was the way Sangakkara batted, completely against his grain. If you look at his hundreds, the hundreds he made, it was all counter-punching. He never allowed bowlers to dictate. He went after the bowling, he was in command, but today he was not in command, he was struggling. He was not able to hit the ball off the square, he was finding the fielders. And when Lahiru Thirimanna was going well at the other end, Sangakkara, 6 of 40, surprised me. So, I don't want to talk about the bowling, because, you know, no bowling side would have won us after we got out for 130 plus. So, I felt that these were, in my opinion, where we really went wrong. And after we made those errors, we had very little time to recover.
Jahan, 133 all out from 69 for 2 at one stage, lost our last 8 wickets for just 64 runs. Other than Thirimanna, Sangakkara and Matthews, nobody else got into double figures. And 9 wicket loss. Where did we go wrong? Is it the team composition?
Not so much the team composition. It's not one particular area that we went wrong in. I think we did a lot of things right in the preparation for the game. Even the combination, I think, was correct. It's unfortunate that Rangana was injured. He would have made difference, but not defending 133. But we did a lot of things right, even winning the toss. I actually was of the opinion that we should bowl first, because our bowling was a bit inexperienced and we might struggle to defend scores. But having seen the wicket and how it was helping the spinners, I changed. I thought, well, it looks actually a good pitch to bowl second. It'll help our slow spinners and the slow bowlers. And I thought it was the right decision to bat first after I saw the wicket behaving. But again, our approach to the batting was what surprised me. we've always had, and we've had a good, as Roshan quite rightly said, we've had a good foundation at the top. Either the openers have put on a good partnership, or we've had a good partnership for the first wicket.
Second wicket.
And that has helped Sangakkara to come in and do his counter-punching, Angelo to come in and accelerate in the middle. But here we lost two wickets in the first two overs, and Thiri comes in into a role where he's not accustomed to. He's played that before, he's not accustomed to that role at this World Cup. He did play his game, he batted well, but he was not getting enough support from the other end with Sangakkara. And there didn't seem to be much thought or planning as to how much we needed to get. The team selection was definitely geared towards the 300, and the batting order was geared towards 300, with them asking Kusal to open. The message was clear, we need to put 300 on the board. But then in the middle, it looked different. It looked a 260-270 wicket. I think Sangha knew that, and the message would have gone back to the dressing room. But it didn't seem to be that we had understood what that, how much we needed to get,
and how to get that.
Okay, the fast bowlers bowled well. They bowled very tight lines. They bowled good lengths. Didn't give a lot for us to get away with. But then again, the spinners came in, and we are supposed to be good players of spin. Tahir is their best spinner, he bowled well, understandably, but he's not as good as we made him out to be. JP Dumini is nowhere near as good as we made him out to be.
Just tell me, we didn't use our feet to the spinners.
We didn't use our feet, we didn't sweep, which we do. I mean, a lot of we play the sweep, the paddle sweeps, the reverse sweeps. We use our field, we trip over the infield. We didn't see any of that, and we didn't even see the intent to do that. Even if you show the bowler just a couple of times you come down the track, you don't need to hit him down the ground. Even defense will give the bowler the impression that you are looking to come after him. You'll give AB the impression, look, we are looking to pick it up a notch, and the bowler might go into containing mode. Maybe if Sangakkara is coming hard at me, okay, I'll give you the single, I'll get Thirimanna on strike and bowl a few dot balls to him. And just the mentality of the bowlers put them on the back foot a bit, shows a bit of intent. The only time Sangha started to show a bit of intent, he got himself out trying to ramp Mokal down to third man.
Just tell me, you know, he's been discussing this. The way Thirimanna got out, did that send a different message to the dressing room?
No, I think that ball stopped on it.
It stopped on it, but that was not the only ball that stopped. There were other balls that stopped in the game. This was highlighted because he got out. But there were other balls that stopped in the game, and I'm sure Sangha, the batsman, knew that.
Jehan, I felt at one stage, if we got 230, 240, we could have still put some pressure. You see, it had a lot to do with the way we batted. Let's look at the way we handled Dumini. I mean, he at one stage, JP Dumini had 6 overs, 20 runs. Yeah. And when he was considered the weak link. You see, we are a nation that is brought up on spin. And we allowed the spinners 7 wickets on that pitch.
And a hat-trick to Dumini.
Yeah, hat-trick, of course, one of those things. I don't think it was, you know, it happened intentionally. It just happens. But allowing them 7 wickets was just...
Even Angelo's dismissal, it seemed... Normally, you would have hit that into the stands.
I got the feeling it had a lot to do with the way Sangakkara batted.
Possibly,
It had a lot to do because Angelo was like, you know, forced to... You know, take some risks. Why did Sangha just bat out of his grain? I mean, he was not batting the way we saw him bat. He was not willing to take on the South African bowlers, as he correctly said. Didn't come down the pitch to the spinner. Didn't play the sweep. Didn't look for the single.
I'm sure it was not about another 100 for him. That's not what was.
I don't think he took him off the groove. But I really don't know. Was it Jehan? Can it be that one thing, and I don't know, this is something you need to tell me. See, one thing is, Sangakkara has already got 400s. Mm-hmm. All eyes were focused on him. Possibly, I don't know whether that pressure was on him. And was it the fact that, you know, Sri Lanka was too focused? I mean, I got the feeling that Sangakkara Mahela looked completely different. Even Mahela looked completely different. I mean, Mahela is a batsman who will come down the pitch, just chip the ball into gaps, make batting look so easy against spinners. But against Tahir, he couldn't read him.
I saw Sangha get 100 against South Africa at the SSC. Yeah. And he played Tahir really, really well. He hit him down the ground for sixes. And he certainly didn't misread him.
Mahela survived an LBW of Tahir. I mean, it showed that he was not reading Tahir at all. I'm surprised. You see, for somebody like Mahela Jayawardene, who's so good against spin, he must be one of the best batsmen going in the world playing spin bowlers.
Give me a break. The Papare is unsurpassed in sports content. And we would invite you to send your tributes to the two legends on papare.com's Mahela Sangha tribute pages. We are talking Sri Lanka's most cherished and celebrated cricketers. They got a chance to bat together. They didn't look like what they had been. 27,000 runs between themselves and countless hundreds. Mahela's lack of form, of course, he played one important inning that got us into our groove at this World Cup. But his lack of form, did that have something to do with his approach to the game?
Is it lack of form or lack of runs?
Lack of confidence. I mean, even Quinton de Kock is also had lack of form, but he spent time in the middle and then found his form, got some runs again. It's just good batsmen, once you spend time in the middle, it'll come to you. It's not something that good batsmen worry about, especially at international level. They know that they're good enough.
This was winner takes it all.
It could be that I feel, and to answer your question as well as to why we were so negative, why Sangha was so negative, it could be that
this was restrained. I don't know.
The final game that he's playing, so much expectations. I mean, we've talked about the expectations on South Africa never having progressed beyond the knockout stages, and that the pressure would tell on them. It seemed to be that the pressure told on us and on our experienced players. I felt that our experience would see us through in pressure situations, but for some reason the pressure seemed to get to us.
The best way of summing this up was the way Thirimanna and Sangakkara batted. You know, normally I would have expected the roles to be reversed.
Yeah.
I would have expected Sangakkara going counter-punching against Morkel and Steyn and taking on the spinners, just releasing the pressure. But you could have seen that Sangha looked so much under pressure, even with Thiri releasing the pressure at the end.
I would have understood something like this also. Okay, get Thirimanna to score and go after the bowling. That would probably surprise South Africa. But what I couldn't fathom was that Sangakkara didn't play the support role. I mean, you're supposed to roll your rotate the strike and then just look that. I mean, not the way he played. I mean, 20 balls to get off the mark is understood. But after 40 balls, you are still
on six.
Under six. 15 is something. I mean, it was not that difficult.
Not to rotate. It's not a 300 wicket, but you can certainly knock it around here. And then, as you correctly said, that set the tone for the rest of the innings. I mean, everybody who came in then was, should I attack? If Sangha is finding it this difficult to score runs, should I try to attack? And that gave the impression that, you know, the wicket is a lot harder than it looks to be. The bowling is a lot tougher than it actually is. And bowlers who generally we wouldn't even think twice about coming down the track and hitting them over mid-wicket, we were thinking twice about it. Ange was double guessing himself. Tisara even maybe was double guessing himself. And the Dumini's hat-trick, he didn't turn. He was just bowling straight and just missed straight balls.
Absolutely straight. Nothing turned.
Just look at that. I mean, we are talking Tisra Pereira. We know that there's a major problem. He's not bowling well. He's not batting anywhere near what he can do. He's not hitting the ball. He's not trying to hit the ball and get out. It's not happening with him. But getting back into the composition of the team, any one of you can answer me. Did we make a mistake or did we overlook certain areas in trying to get too many inexperienced cricketers like Tarindu Kaushal, Dushmant Chamira into this knockout game?
One thing that surprised me is, well, this only the ICC doctors would have confirmed. Hmm. Now, was Herath ruled out of the tournament? Now, what would have been the situation?
Apparently, he was ruled out of the tournament.
Ruled out of the tournament. So then
he cannot come back and play a semi-final.
No, meaning he, I know. But was it being ruled out because he was expected not to get fit?
He was expected not to get fit. The injury would take more than a week to heal. That's
so
what
then that's reasonable. But still, I was a little bit surprised to find Sri Lanka playing two rookies, playing Tharindu Kaushal and playing Dushmant Chamira, both in that same lineup. considering that the Sri Lankan bowling is weak. And what I think is, you know, how would have this duo coped with if South Africa was on the charge?
That was my question about can we defend under pressure.
Yeah.
Tharinda Kaushal debut at a World Cup quarterfinal. Young boy, big,
That's exactly the question, Jihad. So you see, either we should have played Suranga Lakmal and played Tharindu Kaushal, where we bring in experience in the bowling, or left out Tharindu Kaushal and played a more experienced spinner, and still gone with
Samir. We definitely needed another spinner. I mean, we need a spinner, whether we needed another spinner or not, but it's hard to
assess
that.
Another spinner instead of
Tharindu.
Tharindu, because he was so new. Because, you know,
it's hard to assess that because we got only 130.
Yeah. I mean, even the 130, you know, when we were 5 down, 6 down, a little bit of experience could have got us another 50 runs probably. If somebody just stuck there without getting into that hat-trick situation, there would have been a story where Sangakkara passed 50, would have released a little bit of pressure. And you know, maybe another 50, 60 runs, maybe we got to 200. Maybe.
I was hoping 180 at one stage. Honestly, I was thinking 180, bat the 50 overs, get to 180.
It's just that this is a very feeble batting performance. I mean, you go to a quarterfinal, you are psychologically prepared. And we had so many officials handling all these things. It never worked. It didn't look like that. I mean, 11 cricketers would have probably handled it a little bit better.
Yeah, that's a tough one. I also feel that one area we've had a lot of injuries throughout the tournament, and we have never made a like for like replacement.
Exactly.
Dhammika, except for Dhammika Prasad when he got injured, Dushmanta Chamira came in. But thereafter, every replacement has been with an opening batsman when spinner got injured. When Rangan Herath got injured, we brought in an off spinner. Is it because we don't have people good enough to come in? I'm actually surprised that we don't have a good enough left arm spinner in Sri Lanka to, you know, replace Rangan Herath.
Tell me, you're still in the game. You come up with all this top quality stuff. Tell me that we don't have a spinner who could be groomed into that.
We haven't looked at a spinner.
That's another story.
Spinners. The only spinners we have looked at are off spinners like Tharindu Kaushal.
Roshan, tell me, you're in touch with all this?
I don't believe
the fact that we don't have the wherewithal.
No, I'm trying to think of a left-arm spinner. I mean, there are a few in the circuit.
There are only about 4 or 5 in the circuit.
Okay, Malinda Pushpakumara, I don't really think that he can make the grade because he's bowling far too slow. I'm not sure about the way Sohan Borlase bowls at
the point
NCC.
Is that all these guys are there, but they
have
never been
groomed.
Nobody was groomed.
Okay.
None of the left arm spinners were groomed. In case Rangan Herath gets injured, we have no backup. If in case, say, Angelo gets injured, who do we replace Angelo with? If Mahela gets injured, we don't have a shadow team for a national team, which is, I think, what A teams or junior teams should be a shadow team to the national team, which wasn't the case. And in a situation where in a World Cup, suddenly you have one of your key players out through injury, we don't have an adequate replacement.
We are sharing the passion of the 11th ICC Cricket World Cup. This is World Cup News Breakdown. You're with www.thepapare.com, Sri Lanka's number one sports hub. Now, when you're looking at what we've just discussed, I mean, going into this World Cup with aging players and a long tour before the tournament proper, there is always the possibility of breakdowns.
Yes.
I mean, that's where the management has to look into. So, this lack of replacements or lack of identification, that's part of the system that's failing.
It's part of the system, and all the good countries have a good domestic structure. They have a good support system. They have a good under 19, A team tour where you go and play abroad, visit teams, come and play. Hey, we do that, have that with at A team level, but there isn't the structure of the team that plays is not a shadow team. We try out a lot of players at A team level, at under 19 level, and it's more about quality and less about more about quantity and less about quality.
And just to stop you there, Jahan, I think when we look at A-team cricket, sadly, there was a time that Sri Lanka was playing A-team cricket to win, which I don't agree.
Correct.
You see, A-team cricket is all about grooming. That is one. Then let's look at some of the players who can, say, replace our current senior players. I mean, I don't want to talk with Jahan because he's seated next to us, so it's not fair. But let's take...
What's not fair? I mean, he's statistics will perform.
Look, I'm not saying that he should not be. Yeah. I'm just saying. So that's, I'm not picking his name, but I'm say, let's take the name of Malinga Bandara, for example, right? One of Sri Lanka's most experienced spinner we have behind Rangana Herath. Now, in my opinion, Malinga Bandara is not or should not be in the 18 because he's above that 18. And A team should be for youngsters. But I strongly feel, if you want me to bring in his name, we should identify, as you correctly said, we need a shadow 5 or 6, say 2 or 3 top batsmen, 2 or 3 top spinners, who should be always kept on standby just in case to substitute for one of the seniors that breaks down. I'm not in any way saying that A team players could go in. Now, because Sri Lanka looks at the A team for youth. Now, youth is not ready still to take that next step. That's why I think playing Tarendu Kaushal was a mistake. He is a player who has immense potential. And he is going to be the next big thing as far as Sri Lanka cricket is concerned. You know, in fairness, he has no problem with his action. The way he bowls, nobody can point a finger at him. I think he's going to get us lots of wickets. He's going to win us lots of games.
But he has to be groomed in properly.
But he is not ready to play in a World Cup quarterfinal. Now, that place of Rangana Herath should have gone to a senior, experienced spinner if we had somebody in the wings, like he said. You know, when the opener, Dimuth Karunaratne got injured, fair enough, Upul Taranga was the right choice. But why Kusal for Chandimal? You see, you can't, what they're trying to do here, sadly, you're trying to correct a mistake with another mistake. Because in the first place, I felt Kusal should have been picked for this 50-over World Cup because he's a player who can go there and at least be in the squad. You see, but you can't bring him later, bring him at numbers, bring him to replace a number 6 batsman, and then you replace an established opener by throwing him straight away into the deep end.
You know, when you look at it, Sri Lanka had been in the finals of the last 2 Cricket World Cups. Their record in this tournament is exemplary. A lot of teams, including South Africa and New Zealand, envy Sri Lanka for what they've done in the past. And all of a sudden, this particular result and the way Sri Lanka sort of surrendered the match to South Africa gives a wrong impression about the cricket being played in Sri Lanka and the talent that is available and what Sri Lanka should be really doing. This is not considering what is going out, filtering into the international arena about the misgivings of handling cricket in Sri Lanka. Sri Lanka cricket in particular, the handling of the game here in the country. Now, how can Sri Lanka sort of recover from this? I mean, these players, they are very hurt. They have to come back, prepare. They don't have much time. International cricket comes to Sri Lanka. How could they get out of this?
In the same way, you have to be able to put it behind you, but also learn from it. Learn why, you know, why were we not able to perform at that? We can talk about selections and you know, who should have played. We can talk about combinations, but at the end of the day, you're in the middle there and you're facing a bowler or you have to bowl to a particular batsman. If you're an international cricketer, as a professional cricketer, if I'm asked to open in a World Cup quarterfinal, I have to be prepared to do so.
Exactly.
And if I'm asked to bat at number 6, suddenly I'm asked to bat at number 4, I have to be prepared to do so. Why wasn't I able to do that? So I have to look, review my game and see, I should be able to have an all-round game. And we see India do that all the time. They shuffle their batting lineup quite a bit because their players are good enough to adapt to each situation and each condition. And we need to work harder on our game individually rather than picking, saying players, he is an opener, he can only do this role. He is good at hitting the ball. So rather than looking for custom-made situations to put players into, let's build players or build the players that we have to be prepared to face any situation, and that's the solution that will help Sri Lanka cricket in general, and that is what is working for all these successful teams, India, South Africa and Australia.
And let's look at successful players. Take Dilshan, where was he? He was a middle order batsman. Yeah. He changed to be an opener, and today he's one of the most successful going
Even
in the world.
Sanat Jayasuriya was started as a middle order player.
Mahela Jayawardhan, if you look at his record, he's equally good at the top of the order as much as he is in the middle. So as Jahan says very correctly, I mean, it's easy for us to criticize the selectors, it's easy for us to point fingers, but as you say, the players also need to take a huge amount of the responsibility.
Exactly.
Because let's face it, you see, in the modern day, there is enough facilities, there is enough available to the players to go and try to improve their own game. Very quickly, Hartha, cricketers today are starting to use their personal coaches. You see, cricket, though being a team game, they're now making it very individual, and top players are now starting to have their own coach, where they go back and work with their own coach. You see, that's the investment of a cricketer if you want to improve.
Well, it was supposed to be a good end to the wonderful careers of Sangha and Mahela. It didn't turn out that way, but we here would like to wish them all the best in their retirement from One Day International Cricket. And thank you very much for the services and the enjoyment you gave us as a nation, as an individual. We'd like to thank Roshan and Jahan for joining us in this discussion. World Cup is over for Sri Lanka, but the World Cup is not over for cricket. We'll be meeting you very soon.
Fire up your home or office with ultimate speeds. Keep up with the next generation on Dialog 4G. Connect to the fastest network with burst speeds of 40 Mbps. Go 4G with monthly plans starting at just 1,400 rupees. Dialog, the future today.